Hey everyone, thanks for learning to play games. My name is Lance, and in today's video I'm going to look at a brand new game coming to Kickstarter called Old Mage. This is a new one from Pickpocket Press. It is a 1 to 6 player game that takes roughly 1 to 2 hours to play, and is a competitive game where players are going to be competing with each other throughout the game to be the first to accomplish one of two different goals, either to find an ancient relic and make it back to their mage's tower, or to be the last mage standing, eliminating all of their opponents. Whoever achieves this first will be the winner of the game. So in the game itself, the High Wizard has died, and so you as wizards want to take this position and become the new High Wizard. And this isn't a matter of just dueling it out for just a quick little wizard's duel. No, this is to the death. So you are going to try to track down the different relics, proving that you are the best, being able to move around the lands, taking out different monsters, finding the most powerful spells, and blasting your opponents with them, or potentially other monsters. And that, all in the hopes of either eliminating all of your opponents or finding that relic, that orb, and making it back to your wizard's tower. So as always, if you find these videos helpful, if you like what I do, please consider hitting that like button and subscribing to my channel. It's one of the easiest ways you can support channels like mine so we continue to grow and build and produce this content. If you want to stay up to date on all my videos, also give that notification bell a ring, and that'll let you know whenever I drop new stuff, as I'm constantly dropping new videos, including teaching videos, playthroughs, unboxings, and Kickstarter coverage, among many other types of videos. So if you want to stay up to date, hit that bell. So let's go ahead and head to the table, and we'll see what this one's all about. The one other important thing I do want to point out before getting into the video is that all the materials you see here are prototype materials and are subject to change, and will look a lot better in the final production copy of the game. The first thing I want to start by looking at are the wizards you're going to get to play, as that is the most important thing. Everybody wants to play a wizard casting powerful spells, and so here is your opportunity. Each wizard is going to have their own card that is going to list the name of that wizard at the top, their image, and their special ability that makes them unique. In the middle of the card is going to be a turn summary, so you can have an outline of what you can do during your turn, and then each one of the wizards is going to start with 10 health. Now, throughout the game, the players are going to slowly lose health over time, and if a wizard ever loses all of its health, you're going to flip its card over, and it's going to become a haunt. And these are going to work a little bit differently, and their turn structure is going to be listed here. Now, you will lose the special ability of your wizard, as all of the haunts work exactly the same way. And if you are able to roll doubles, or the same result on both dice when you roll them, you will become an undead mage, and you'll get to flip your card back over and regain 5 health. But at that point, if you get eliminated again or lose all of your health again, then you are out of the game from this point on. And there are going to be 6 different wizards included, including the Wind Walker, the Ruin Seer, Storm Witch, Ancient One, the Mage Priest, and the Necromancer. Now, you wouldn't be much of a wizard without some really powerful spells, and so there's going to be an entire deck of spells that you're going to be able to cast throughout the game, and each player is going to be drawing spells from this deck, and so nobody will really know what you have. And these are going to be all kinds of different spells, each one listing the range of that spell and the type of spell that it is, and if it gets any bonuses based on the different land that you're casting it from, then you'll have the effects of that spell that you'll carry out after that. And there's going to be all kinds of different spells, including calling lightning or bending time, hell blast, freezing fog, and arcane mirror, just to name a few. There are also 3 other decks that players are going to be interacting with throughout the game. The first is the event deck, and this deck is going to have all kinds of different events in it that the players are going to have to resolve when drawing cards from it. Some of these events will be good, some will be bad, and some will be neutral. Next, you're going to have your relic deck, and this is going to have powerful relics that will help the players along the way. And then, obviously, the most important one is the Master Orb. If you can get this one, this is one of the ways that you can win the game, by collecting this card and then making it back to your starting space. And then finally, you have the Ruin cards, and these are going to have powerful monsters in them and powerful spells that you can gain and really help you turn the tide of battle. All right, and the final thing I want to do is take you through a sample, a couple turns, and kind of explain the flow of the game. So getting into it, you'll have to select one of your players to be the starting player. I'm going to go ahead and have the Mage Priest be the starting player. And so during a player's turn, they have a couple of different options that they can do. And you can do these in any order you want. The first thing is to move. In order to do that, you're going to roll a pair of blue dice, and based on the number of little footprints that you get on those will be the number of spaces you can move or hexes you can move. Now, there are some limitations to that where you cannot particularly move through water spaces under certain conditions and whatnot. The other option is, instead of moving, you can choose to camp, which will allow you to heal two of your wounds or heal two health. From there, you can choose to cast a spell, and you're only allowed to cast one spell during your turn. Now, there are some stipulations to that. You can cast one spell in battle, which doesn't count against your turn, and you can also use interrupt spells without them counting as the one spell that you use during your turn. And then finally, you will resolve an encounter. Some of these different steps are optional, so you don't have to. If you land on one of the different token spaces, you will reveal those, and that could be a monster that you'll have to fight, which you'll have to resolve in the encounter. If you are on a ruin, then you can draw a ruin card and resolve that. Or if you're on an empty hex, then you can also choose to draw an event card and handle that. Now, if you're on an empty hex, you don't have to draw an event card. Again, that is an optional part. Or if you're already on a space that has a monster, then you'll have to do a battle or another player. Now, the one important thing is if you're on the same space as another mage, if both of you choose to, you can choose not to battle. That is totally up to you as the players. You can strike deals or come to an agreement or terms or however you want to do that. So moving in, let's look at an example of that. So let's go ahead and take a look at the mage priest. So let's go ahead and say that he wants to move. So he ends up rolling pretty well at five spaces. So let's go one, two, three, four. And let's go into this mountain space just to see what it is. So that's our fifth space. And we found a monster of some sort. Looks like a... could be an old giant. He looks like he's crutching on a little cane there or something. Pretty weak, only uses one black die for his attack, and he's only got one hit point. So we'll have to resolve that next. So we can choose to cast a spell, and let's go ahead and handle the encounter next. So we'll jump into that, fighting our little guy there. And so we know he's going to use a black die to attack us, and we will always roll as mages two attack dice. Now, we can also cast one spell in battle, so I have some options here. So this one lets me place a token. I can steal a card from one target. At the end of your turn, you may lose one health to draw a spell. If swamp, also draw a spell. So I don't really have anything at the moment that's going to do a lot of good for this one, so I'm not going to cast a spell in combat. And so then at this point, now that I've decided not to cast a spell, you were not allowed to cast a spell after you roll dice. So let's go ahead and roll and see what we get. So I have two shields, so I'm not going to take any damage, hopefully, but I'm not dishing any damage out either. And he does two swords, so my two shields do cancel that out. And so the whole battle is a wash, and that is the end of that. Now that I've completed this pass, then it would move on to the next pass, and this is going to continue until either I choose to flee as the mage or I'm able to eliminate the opponent that I'm going up against. With this particular monster, I have to deal a damage to him. Now, with this, with monsters, they also will heal at the end of each pass, so you have to kill them outright. So moving back in, let's go ahead and try it one more time. So my mage is going to go ahead and roll two to his one. So let's go ahead and roll his first, and he rolls a shield this time. So this time I need at least two swords, and I got four. All right, so I definitely am going to defeat him, and so he is going to be eliminated in that situation. Now, like I said, this could continue going back and forth until either the mage is defeated or the enemy is defeated, or I choose to flee. So at the end of each pass, I could choose to flee, moving to an adjacent space, and then that is going to end that particular combat. So the other thing with this is then, again, during my turn now, I've already handled my move and my encounter, so at this point, I could choose to cast a spell if I wanted to, but again, I don't necessarily think I have a spell at the moment that's going to help me. This one lets me heal, the lichen form lets me heal one health at the end of your turn. This spell lasts until you become a haunt. If water, also draw a spell. But yeah, I don't think there's anything I want to do with that at this point. And then at the end of my turn, my particular mage also gets to heal a health. So if I had taken damage in combat, then I would get to heal on from the, just at the end of my turn. From there, it would pass over to the next player to take their turn. And again, that player would handle the same thing. And this is how the game works. So you're going to be moving around, trying to find the different things, defeating monsters, and being able to hopefully eliminate your opponents before they eliminate you. Or if you're lucky enough to find one of those ruin orbs by going into the ruins on the map and then making your way back to your home. Well, I hope this gives you a good idea how the game plays. As always, if you have any questions or comments, please post those in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Or swing by the Kickstarter's main page and drop any questions you have there as well. I'm sure the creators would love to hear from you and are more than happy to answer any questions you have. Until next time, I'll see you later.